In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Mary died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May Mary now share with Christ eternal glory.
By the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their dark
Let us pray. O God, who alone are able to give life after death, free your servant Mary from all sins, that Mary, who believed in the resurrection of your Christ, may, when the day of resurrection comes, be united with you in glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Kindly be seated. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are at peace. For if to others indeed they seem punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. If we live for the Lord, and if we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God, for it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then, each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, Father, my disciples are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I made known to them your name, and I will make it known that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them. The Gospel of the Lord. Kindly be seated. Dear friends, we gather here in our sanctuary to honor and to cherish the memory of Mary. As Jesus speaks of his companions as gifts of his heavenly Father, so we also speak of Mary as a gift of God our Father to all of us. We frequently look to the New Testament book of Revelation. There we find this consoling reassurance and promise. Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds go with them. Although Jen will speak today after Holy Communion about Mary's good deeds, each of us here today carries within our hearts our own particular list of Mary's good deeds. We have addressed our God in prayer today as the one who is alone able to give life after death. As heirs to the Christian biblical tradition, we believe that God, the Almighty Father, has already decisively displayed this power to give life after death by raising Jesus, his only begotten Son, from the dead on the third day, Easter Day. The sacrament of baptism plunges us all into the death of Jesus and brings us up out of the waters as sharers in the new, risen life of Jesus. Dear friends, we spend our days on earth, our allotted time, doing our best to live in this newness of risen life with Jesus and the great company of his followers and friends. In today's prayer over the offerings of bread and wine, we will make this prayer request of God the Father, that Mary, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge. Dear friends, may these words, the songs and the prayers of the funeral ritual, bring you some measure of strength and consolation today and for the days ahead. Kindly stand for the prayers of the faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Jesus Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save all his people, living and dead. To each petition, please reply, Lord, hear our prayer. For Mary, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. For Mary, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased relatives, neighbors, and friends, for all who have helped us, we pray particularly today for Thomas, James, and George. We ask that you give them an eternal home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in the joy and peace of God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters, cleanse them of their sins, and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Kindly be seated. May I now invite Claire and Susan to carry the gifts up the steps to the altar.
I dream of a morning in spring. Bye.
As we humbly present to you the sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Mary, we beseech your mercy that Mary, who did not doubt your son Jesus to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord God, Father Almighty, and Eternal God, for Christ our Lord. For Jesus is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat his bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Mary, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Mary, who was united with your son Jesus in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your grace we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Dear friends, as you come forward to receive Holy Communion, please hold your hand out flat to receive communion. Thank you for your cooperation in this matter. Kindly stand. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Mary, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of happiness, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. Kindly be seated for Jen's words of remembrance.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Jenny Vanderjagt, but I was born Jenny Nicholson, so maybe some of you went to high school with me, I'm not sure. The family honored me by asking me to say a few words about Mary, otherwise known as Ma. I want to tell you folks a little bit about her. I remember her from high school. I was slightly afraid of her, because she had like such rowdy kids, and I was always hearing my dad talk about them and stuff. Little did I know. To my delight, Claire moved back to Franklin about 12 years ago to come and help with Ma. And I learned that Mary, in 1963, with her family, came with her family and stayed here for the rest of her life. She was a nurse at Medfield State Hospital for many years. She worked with people who had disabilities. She talked when life was real, and she didn't sugarcoat things at all. She was also a volunteer for Friends of Medfield, an organization which obtained funding through donations for the good of the hospital. Mary was also a member of the, Hummel Club, Hummel, and has an amazing collection of these figurines. Her other hobbies included knitting and reading tons of books. Every time I'd come to that house, there'd be a stack of books right there. Once in a while, Mary enjoyed trips to Foxwoods and Mohegan Sun, also going to New Jersey when the opportunity presented itself. She was a lifetime loyal parishioner who loved and supported St. Mary's Church. She was a religious woman who loved her God and had strong belief in the powers of prayer. Mary was mother to three children, James, also known as Seamus, who predeceased her in 2014, Kevin, and her only daughter, Claire. Her daughter-in-law, Susan, and her grandsons, Jason and Adam, were a delight to her. She loved their visits and loved to visit them. Post-COVID, time was spent watching her game shows, her special soaps, The Young and the Restless, and Bold and Beautiful. For evenings, she loved Jeopardy and Wheel of Fortune. I'm going to miss her dearly. I loved her and looked forward to seeing her every time I came to Franklin. I believe she is in the arms of her Savior and is finally reunited with her son, Seamus James, as he was called. Rest well, Ma. Thank you.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Mary, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Mary again and enjoy her love and friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow today, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Mary, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is dead. However, in your sight, may she live forever. In your goodness, grant Mary everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In trust, hope, and peace, let us take Mary to her place of rest.